Alright guys, today we're going to be talking about sponges, and later on in the video, cnidarians as well. Sponges are part of the phylum Porifera, named so because of their porous ectoderm. They're also sessile, meaning stationary, either on the ocean floor or whatever rock they happen to be born on. But they have to eat somehow, and they can't go around like fishes and gobble up whatever they see. So what they do is they filter feed, drawing in water from their pores and filtering for whatever food particles they can find. Now, being sessile makes it hard to reproduce. So what they do is they either send out clouds of sperm or eggs, depending on what they choose to be, and they reproduce that way, or asexually, using budding or regeneration. Being sessile or stuck on the ground, they fall into the benthic category of organisms and never leave where they are. Now, sponges have two layers, the endoderm, which is the inside, and the ectoderm, which is the outside. But in between these two layers is the mesenchyme, this substance, I guess you could say, that separates the two. Now, sponges get pretty big, as you can see here. So there's a lot of them, and they do have commercial usage. The most common known is the sponge, so the organic sponge, I guess you can say, the first sponge. Cnidarians are part of the phylum Cnidaria. These include hydras, jellyfish, and anemones. Cnidarians have radial symmetry, meaning no matter what way you cut them, they're going to look the same on each side. Now, jellyfish have two layers to them. The outside is the epidermis, and the inside is the gastrodermis. In between them is a jelly-like substance known as mesoglia, and their inside cavity is the gastrovascular cavity. Now, it's important to know also that they are only made up of tissue and they have no organs. Okay, the fun part. Now, all cnidarians, have this little thing called a cnidocyte. And what it does is it has a wound up barb, like you'll see right here. And when activated by touch, it injects a venom of sorts, and to paralyze the prey, depending on the size, of course. For humans, it's a little different. And that is how it catches its prey and defends itself from predators. So there are three types of cnidarians. First is the scyphozoa, as we see here, which is all of our typical jellyfish in the ocean. And they reproduce sexually, so male and female. Male impregnates the female, and we get a bunch of little guys. Our next group is the anthozoa, which make up our anemones and polyps, basically, all except the manowar, which is a floating polyp. And they reproduce asexually, so by budding regeneration. It works the same for coral, which is also a cnidarian. And our last group is the hydrozoa, which is made up of our hydras. And these guys are asexual and unicellular. So, well, that's it. Thanks for listening and giving me your time. See you later.